I told you that you were the most motherly person that I know. Do you remember that? But it's because it's just in her heart. She doesn't even, it's not an effort for her. It's just natural to take care of people, to cook for Brianna or Dana, you know, when she doesn't want the vegetables. Okay, back to serious business. My next question for you. I remember when your grandmother fell ill and she went to the hospital. And I remember I barely knew you at that time. But you know, when you came forward with your advocacy of active aging and having improved her elderly care, it really reminded me of that moment because I know how much she meant to you. And this is all stuff that I'm not even thinking of. Like, I saw how you felt about her. And, you know, how did you decide that you were going to make your grandma your inspiration for your books?
I first time saw the fight of how my grandma deteriorated. And it was brutal for me growing up, being very, very close to my grandparents. They're the ones who completed me in a way that I used to be always sad about not having my father beside me. So I didn't have a fatherly figure, but all throughout I had my grandparents together with me, completed my life, gave me the love that I received. And after a while, I saw people leaving in our family groups, getting married, and then there was this one sentence she told me that if you were ever going to be in an elderly care hub, I would rather you leave me alone. And I put that in my heart every day of my thinking of how to help, how to showcase my stand and my advocacy. I chose the elderly care, even when there were people who did not believe in me because they said, oh, how can you showcase elderly care? They can't smile on videos. They're too sad. Well, at the back of my mind, that's the point. How can you make them smile? How can you make them happy? How can you touch their lives? And the thing about it, guys, it's so simple. You just give time for them. Make them relevant. Make them feel special. It's already in their sense of years. You know, we're all getting older one day. I mean, matigong matadiba. Do we want to share the same experience of what they're experiencing right now? I mean, it's a preventive precaution. If you guys don't want to experience that, then give love to them. Show more in an elderly care hub. I love Gazini Ganados, guys. I've been there a couple of times. And the way for me to time travel is to read books. Either that, listen to your grandparents, because they always have the greatest wisdom that they can give you, the values that they can share to you.
That's what she does. With every step she puts forward, not only her best book,
Cebu's best food, and not just to the world, but to the universe. Now, this has been a long time coming for you to come home back to Cebu. I know we're all curious. Who was the first phone call that you made when you found out that you were finally coming back home to Cebu?
My mother, of course, because she's the first person to know everything about my schedule. I have not been seeing her a lot because I've been hectic towards my schedule in Manila. And it's so hard when you know you have that advocacy that you're protecting, but at the same time you're also having your mom getting left behind in Cebu. But any other how? I was so excited when I called my mom. I said, "Ma, I'm coming home." The one you know, this was supposed to be in June, and then this was moved and moved and moved, and now finally it's already September, and I got to see you all. So I'm so happy.
And what is the first thing that you ate when you got back? In your homecoming trip this time.
I look forward to seeing all of you being here in Exxon.
Okay, now since becoming Miss Universe Philippines, how's your life changed? What are the things that you do now that you didn't before? What are the things that you do differently?
The Miss Universe organization, having us with the projects that we're working on, all together with the organizations that we're supporting. The things that I get to do is the work that I have right now, the passion that I have right now is much more hectic than before, because as you know guys, Miss Universe has bigger responsibility, bigger shoes to fulfill, and I am happily doing that, rendering my service, catering the Filipinos, and also having to showcase my advocacy in front of a lot of people, and that's already a genuine honor for me.
And speaking of Miss Universe, there has been recent concern as to whether, or where rather, Miss Universe will be held. At the moment, do you have any idea of where it will officially be held?
Pinahan mo sa Pilipinas.
If Miss Universe is here, and if it's here in the Philippines, then aren't we all gonna go make our way to cheer for Gazini? You really do need a Cebuana. Okay, so what is the secret? I'm just going through my mind of all these questions that I want to ask you. Before we open the floor to our crowd, what does it take to be Miss Universe Philippines?
I guess it takes courage and a leap of faith. All you gotta do is to just believe in that you, the inner you, the one who is making you who you are, because you're unique. You gotta trust in that and have a leap of faith. And always, always pray.
You, Gazini, are very, very unique. There's only one person I know in the world whose name is Gazini. You don't even need a last name anymore, but you have a beautiful one at that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to